Hi friends, welcome to another video of Big Tech Talk. In today's video, we will try to create new user, role, and set privileges using Elasticsearch and Kibana. So let's get started. My Elasticsearch and Kibana is up and running. So I will log into Kibana with the username and password, which we have already generated in the previous video. To have a better understanding about user, their role and privileges, we need to push some sample data into Elasticsearch. Luckily, Elasticsearch provides some sample data to work on it. To add some data, click on Load a Dataset. As you can see, we have three types of sample data. Let's add flight and e-commerce. Once data is loaded, click on the management icon and find the role option at the bottom. Let's create a role by clicking on the create role button. Mention the role name. I will name it as read_e-commerce. Scroll down under index privileges. Select your index, that is Kibana sample data e-commerce. Under the privileges, make it as read and create role. Now let's create one more role for the flight data. Select your index, that is Kibana sample data flights, and the privileges, that is read privilege, and click on create role. Once roles are defined, let's create two users and assign these roles to them. So click users under the security. Click on create new user. Over here, we need to mention the username and the password. So the first username can be e-commerce_user. I will keep the password as same, e-commerce user. Confirm password. For the time being, we can skip the full name and the email address. Click on the role and assign the role, that is read e-commerce, and the Kibana user also, because this user will be used to transfer data from Elasticsearch to Kibana. Now create user. Again, let's create one more user for our flight data. flight_user, put the password as same, skip full name and the email address. Under the role, select read flights and the Kibana. So we are all set with two users and their roles. Let's log out and log in with the flight user. Now let's go to the dashboard and have a look to the flight data. Click on the flight dashboard. Yes, we can view our flight demo data. Now let's go and see the e-commerce dashboard. We can see the dashboard, but not the data. So the flight user can only see flight data, not the e-commerce. This is because flight user has access to the flight index only. Now let's log out and log in with the e-commerce user. Again, go to the dashboard and click on e-commerce dashboard. Yeah, we can see the e-commerce sample data over here. Again, let's go to the dashboard and see the flight data. Only the dashboard is visible, not the data. So, we have successfully set up two users with the restricted access on the index. So friends, if you like the content, hit the like button and subscribe for more such videos. Thank you.